A check on European markets. They are mixed in afternoon trade. The DAX index down a fifth of a percent as data showed industrial orders in Germany fell more than expected in August, adding more worries over the manufacturing sector of the region's biggest economy. Also keeping sentiment in check, a slate of speakers from European Central Bank policymakers this Monday. For Wall Street, futures are in the red after a winning week last Friday. Rate-sensitive mega-cap growth stocks are coming under pressure following a rise in U.S. Treasury yields, with the yield on the benchmark 10-year notes touching its highest since early August. Asian markets kicked off the new trading week mostly higher. This is as they got their chance to react to Friday's better-than-expected jobs data from the U.S., which eased fears of a recession in the world's biggest economy. Japan's Nikkei 225 led gains with a rally of 1.8%. The Hong Kong Hang Seng also among top performers, with the index hitting the 23,000 level for the first time since February 2022. The Hang Seng has rallied for about 2 weeks now after the Chinese government announced a slew of stimulus measures since late September. The PSEI also marking a milestone, with the main index closing above 7,500 for the first time in 2 years.
It's still a good chance to come in, but admittedly, the best time to have bought more, if you weren't in it, was before the first rate cut, right? Mm. Because we were at the 6.7, 6.8 levels. Now you have to be really selective on what you'll buy, because there might be less aggressive swings already. But then, as you know, people are still taking profits, so you just you trade on the swings. But in general, a lot of the corporates, at least, parang bumalik na yung dating valuation nila.
A notable stock movement in the region, Nintendo shares surged 4.5% in Monday trade. That's after Saudi Arabia's sovereign wealth fund said it is considering raising its holdings in Japanese gaming companies. Billionaire tycoon Elon Musk makes his first appearance at a Trump campaign. Speaking at a rally in Pennsylvania, where Trump was nearly assassinated last July, Musk urged the crowd to register and vote, saying the Republican candidate must win to preserve democracy.
The true test of someone's character is how they behave under fire. And we had one president who couldn't climb a flight of stairs, and another who was fist pumping after getting shot. Fight, fight, fight! Blood coming down the face. Now, America is the home of the brave. And there's no truer test than courage under fire. So that, who do you want representing America? Yeah, absolutely. President Trump must win to preserve the Constitution. He must win to preserve democracy in America. Yes. This is a must-win situation.
Meanwhile, in a separate rally, Trump said he would slap tariffs as high as 200% on vehicles imported from Mexico. That's double from his previous promise as he ramps up his protectionist trade rhetoric ahead of the November 5 elections.